say. And you hate that you know, you know, you know, you know you messed up. One day you'll love me again. One day you'll love me for sure. One day you'll wake up feeling how I've been feeling, baby. You knock at my door. One day you'll love me again. Help me again for the end. One day you'll make me cry. One day you'll realize I'm home.
Welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a very long time since I uploaded, and I mean like really uploaded, not just like a 2-minute, 4-minute, 3-minute video. It's been a minute. I believe it's been almost a year, and there's a reason for that. You know, I had to take some me time, reevaluate myself, and come back on here when I was ready. So as you guys can tell from the back, there's a blank wall behind me, and as most of you guys already know, I put it all over my social media that I got my own 2-bedroom apartment, and I am so freaking excited to share a quick life update video with you. I kind of already gave you a snippet of what's been going on, but if you want to hear more about it, then please keep on watching. I'm gonna be drinking. Ooh. Maybe I shouldn't be drinking. But I'm gonna be drinking a glass of wine as I tell you guys what's been going on in my life and about my new apartment. So go ahead and grab your drink, grab your Cheetos, whatever. Just get comfortable, okay? It's gonna be a long story. I'm gonna try not to be emotional and cry because lately I've been so fucking emotional about every fucking thing that has happened. I remember the feeling I got whenever I got the keys to my apartment, and it was just insane how everything happened. Look at me, my eyes are getting watery. Oh my gosh. Despite on how, why I got my apartment, well, basically the why, I'm gonna tell you the how. The why I got my apartment, nevertheless, I'm thankful for it. I'm thankful for the why, and that's all I will say about that. So back to, you know, the whole situation. So I had to, like, basically get this apartment by Friday morning. I had to already like get settled in and stuff like that, so I got everything done in less than 48 hours, which is freaking insane. I have a lot of stuff, I have a lot of clothes and stuff like that, so thankfully I had my two cousins and my brother help me out. We filled up three cars. That means the trunk, the back seat, the front seat, and yeah, it was a lot of stuff that I had to take. And then that wasn't even all of the stuff that I had to like take. And there was still more, three cars and then some. And then to organize all of that, some of the stuff is still in boxes. Well, not boxes, but containers that I have to organize. It's just little things. As you guys can already tell on my like Facebook and my Instagram, I basically have my beauty room set up already. There's a lot of little tiny details that, you know, obviously I want to add to it, like frames and stuff like that. But my kitchen is basically complete. I have my dining table. I have my sectional couch. I'll probably insert a picture somewhere over here. And my bedroom and my closet is all organized right now, so yeah. I kind of like don't know how I really don't know how to explain the feeling that I had when I first got my apartment keys. Like whenever she was like, surprise, you got approved, I was just in shock. I was like, what? I got approved? Like, I've been working since February to build up my credit. It's been my biggest goal to move out of my parents' house for a very long time, but as you know, shit happens, life happens, and I was never really financially able to afford to move out, or at least I told myself that, and never really did the research behind it and what it takes to move out and how much I need to save in order to move out. And I just kind of like went off of a bubble, you know, like I had to have this much, but like never really like stayed to the plan of moving out, figuring it out, like investigating and doing my research, you know. I kind of just went with the flow. Okay, so with that being said, like I took a huge leap of faith applying for an apartment and getting approved, and not just a one bedroom, a two bedroom apartment. And it's been my dream to have a two bedroom because I always wanted one of the rooms to be my workspace and dedicate that to my YouTube channel and just have like my own beauty room, you know. And now I have it, and I shit you not that as soon as I walked in my apartment, I looked around. I had already seen it when I was like looking around an apartment. And the funny thing is, I ended up going to other apartments and I ended up leaving my ID at the front desk. Well, she forgot to give it to me, and so I was like, no big deal, I'll just turn around and go back. And then all of a sudden, like, she tells me about, you know, the application fees and all that stuff, and like how easy it can be, it's like close by, like to get a money order and all that. And so I went ahead and I just submitted my application. I went off my gut feeling and I was like, okay, just do it. And so I did it, and then I was on my way to another one, and then she calls me back and says, hey, like you got approved and stuff. And I'm just like, whoa, like that was quick. And it's crazy, it's just crazy how I was in the area and everything happened. And I strongly believe everything happens for a reason. And the thing about the difference between this apartment complex and other apartment complexes was that this specific apartment that I'm in right now was an immediate move-in, so it was available to move in today. And that was like the goal for that day, to move in today. And so I called in other places and they were like, oh, we can have you moved in by October 9th, and it was October 1st. That day was October 1st, and I was like, dude, like I need to move in today, not in a week from now, not 2 days from now, not like the latest that I was willing to move in was probably like October 2nd. But even then, it was just, I couldn't wait anymore. You know, due to personal situations that I was dealing with, I couldn't wait any longer. I had to go. And I came back and we toured the apartment again, and she was like, so, you know, is it either yes or no? And I was like, yes, yes, 1,000 times yes. And she gave me my key and it said welcome home. And then I drove over here and I walked in, and you know, I saw the living room, I went to, you know, I saw the kitchen, dining room again. Went into the restroom, and I was all like, you know, I didn't have any words for the feeling that I was feeling. And then I walked into, you know, the room that I knew that was gonna be my beauty room, and I was like, okay, okay. And then for some reason, I walked into the master bedroom, and I just started crying. Like, I broke down crying, like, something had hit me, and I was just filled with so much gratitude, and I just started crying a lot. Ugh, I did my makeup, I don't want to cry. I was so thankful, grateful, and beyond blessed to like have been approved. I couldn't have asked for a better apartment, honestly. And to have done this on my own, if I would have known it would have been this easy to move out and and stuff, I would have probably done it a lot sooner. But I guess what I'm trying to say is we tend to put restrictions on our goals because we have so much fear instilled inside of us and we're afraid to take that leap of faith. What I'm trying to tell you guys is trust your gut instinct, and if you want to do something, stop at nothing until you conquer it. And one of my biggest goals was, like I told y'all before, it was to move out and to have my own space, something I can call my own. And it's something that I just decided to just go after, and despite of, like, you know, what might have happened, I'd rather have applied to like 3 or 4 apartments and gotten denied than to not have applied at all and just been wondering what if. I had to go through certain situations in order to grow, and sometimes, you know, the universe gives you a little kick in the butt in order for you to move towards your goals, which is what I feel that the universe and, you know, God and everyone just did for me, because I wouldn't have done it like by myself. I wouldn't have done it without the why I moved out. So if you really want something, just go for it, trust your gut, and just do it. Just freaking do it. If moving out is a goal, then 1, 3 advice that I can give you: save up some money. Put aside $50, $100 every paycheck that you get, or even if it's a car that you want or anything like that, just start working towards it. You can't just ask for it and be like, oh, I wish I had this, I wish I had that. Like, no. Life is not, it doesn't work that way. You have to put in the work in order to get results. And you think if I would have just stayed on my butt and just said, I wish I could have my own place, I would be where, you know, I would have what I have. No, I would still be at my parents' house being where I was and not flourishing and not going out of my comfort zone. So trust that things happen for a reason and accept them, even if it's bad, quote unquote bad, and you're like, why does this happen to me? Instead of saying, why does this happen to me, say, what are you trying to teach me, God? What lesson is this applying towards my life? What lesson do I have to learn here? And just change your mentality. The day you start changing your mentality is the day you grow and surpass your goals, reach your goals, you know? This is the start of something new, and I know it's gonna be amazing. I have this amazing feeling in my chest, in my stomach, that, I don't know, I just can't help but smile. And it still feels surreal to me. I feel like I'm just gonna wake up out of a dream and just be like, you know? I'm so beyond thankful, so happy, so grateful. This is a huge milestone for me, and even though some of you might be like, oh, you know, this, someone is always gonna have something to say about your success. But you think by someone saying that something about my success is gonna affect the way I feel about it? No. The fact that I feel like this is a huge accomplishment is not gonna change based off of, you know, so-and-so's opinion about what I wear and why. Like for example, like if some people say, oh, you know, your apartment isn't as nice or what, I don't give a fuck. Like, I'm grateful for what I have. I am so thankful, grateful, and everything. Like, who cares? Just go after your goals, crush them, and get ready for the next milestone that you're gonna go ahead and reach, you know? This is just one of my first milestones that I have achieved, and there's so many more that I have in mind. But yeah, guys, I feel like that's all I really much have to say about this right now. I guess I don't really know what to name this video, but it's kind of like a life update kind of thing of, you know, where I'm at right now and my headspace. And if you guys haven't subscribed yet, make sure you subscribe, because there's gonna be a lot more videos coming out, you guys, especially during October. Ooh, I hope you guys are ready. If you guys have any questions, anything to say, just go ahead and comment down below. Don't be shy. And yeah, follow me on my socials. It'll be down in the description box below or above. I don't know. I've been gone on YouTube for too long. Do they still have description boxes? Like, I don't know. But yeah, guys, I will see y'all in the next video. Love you guys. Bye.